My name is Marijke Hermans. I'm a PhD candidate here at the faculty, and I did a bachelor in arts and culture, and then I continued with a research master in cultures of arts, science and technology, so I have a very interdisciplinary background. The title of my research is preliminary, the risk of risk framing, the case of wireless communication technology. So in my project, I'm interested in the role of technology and new innovations on society. And I'm particularly interested in new developing technologies that need a big infrastructures to be implemented. And a particular technology that I have chosen is wireless communication technology. So, and then of course these also need to be implemented because we need to make our mobile phones work. So what you often see is that people are worried when they notice that a base station, so a mast or an antenna, has to be sited in their neighborhood. So what we did recently is try to map the instances of these local mast siting controversies. And as you can see on the map, you have red dots and green dots, and they indicate whether a green dot in that case, in that particular municipality, there were no troubles about the siting of a base station. But if you see a red dot, it means that people were actually worried about it. They called the municipality, for example, and we only were able to research half of the municipalities, but this already indicates this map that is quite a lot of instances of these local mast siting controversies. The thing that I find really interesting about my research is that we're actually dealing here with a technology that we all use. Everybody has a mobile phone, we all want to check our emails on it, and we really cannot think, like, leave out the technology of our modern lives anymore. But at the same time, it also ignites public concern at this very local level where you have to implement the technology. So I find this a very interesting contradiction, and I would like to find out more about it. I think it's a very good research environment for PhD candidates, because you're really part of the research community. So you can go to the meetings that are planned, you can really talk to senior colleagues, and they really are curious about your work. So I think you're really involved here in the research community, and that's really important for me. As a PhD candidate, you're also part of the Graduate School of the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences. And so that's another community you're part of. It's amongst junior researchers, so all PhD candidates. And there you really get valuable feedback on your research, and you have meetings twice a month. Anything that you could be thinking of that would be relevant for a PhD candidate is discussed in these meetings. And it's a very open environment where you can discuss amongst peers what you're dealing with during your PhD.